healthy diet is an important part of healthy lifestyle at any time, but it is very vital when you are pregnant or you are planning for pregnancy. Pregnancy doesn't require any special diet, but at the same time, it's very important to add nutrition and have a balanced and healthy diet in pregnancy. Is there any magic formula for pregnancy healthy diet? What are the myths in pregnancy? Why there is a cravings of food in pregnancy? What you should eat, what you should avoid, all about diet in this video. Do listen till end, and if you have any question, please feel free to ask me in the comment section. As I said, there is no magic formula about pregnancy diet, but it's also important to add a healthy and nutritious diet in pregnancy and see to it that you add all the different categories of the food in your diet. So in a day, your diet should have at least 5 servings of fruits and vegetables, which may include green leafy vegetables, orange colored vegetables and citrus fruits. Then you should have at least 6 servings of the complex carbohydrate, like whole grains, millet, cereals, rice, breads. You should have at least 3 servings of the protein, which may include lean meat, then eggs, chicken, then peanut butter and beans and peas. Then you should have at least 2 to 3 servings of the dairy product which contain the calcium, like milk, cheese, paneer. Then in the vegetables which contain the calcium are the spinach and broccoli. Then you should have at least 8 to 10 glasses of water you should drink in a day, and you should have at least 1 to 2 servings of the food which contain the iron, because iron deficiency anemia is very common in India. So the food contain the iron are the lean meat, then green leafy vegetable, then like spinach, then fruits like pomegranates, and dry fruits like or nuts like raisins and dates. All this will give you the iron. Now, though you may be taking iron, folic acid and calcium from the first trimester or second trimester, but you should always add the food which contain all this. So if you talk about the folic acid is a B vitamin which prevent neurological neurotubal defect, and it prevents so many other spinal cord and neurological problems. So it is very important to add folic acid. Even if you take the folic acid tablet, but add the fruit which contain the folic acid. And the important sources of folic acids are legumes, then beans, peas, then citrus fruit, and now fortified cereals are also available which contains the folic acid. Then coming to the calcium, calcium promotes teeth and bone growth of your baby, and it is also required for the nervous, muscular and circular system to function normally. And the good sources of calcium are dairy products like milk, cheese, yogurt. Then vegetables like spinach, broccoli are the good sources of calcium. And if you talk about the iron, iron deficiency anemia is very common in India, and in pregnancy also, in the second trimester, there is a physiological anemia in the woman, and iron deficiency anemia leads to the preterm delivery or low birth weight baby. So you have to take the iron supplement from the second trimester, but add on the diet as we have discussed, which contain the iron, like green leafy vegetable, like nuts, like lean meat, which contain the iron. Now, there are so many myths in pregnancy. The common myths are eat for two. Elders always advise pregnant ladies to eat for two. This is so untrue. You should never eat for two. The requirement of food, the food requirement in first trimester is hardly increased in pregnant women, and second and third trimester it is marginally increased. You should never eat for two. You should eat small and frequent meals. You should concentrate more on the quality than the quantity, and you should see to it that you include healthy and nutritious diet and avoid lot of sugary, salty and the diet which contain lot of fried foods. You should avoid in pregnancy. Then the second is eating light colored food will make your baby fair, and eating dark colored beverages like tea and coffee will make your baby dark colored. This is not true at all. Your baby is your genetic replica. So whatever features and colors you and your husband have, the baby is going to have the same. Why on earth you want your baby to look different than you? So it's a myth that you should have, in fact, you can have tea and coffee, but in moderation. You can drink coconut water. They said coconut water will make your baby fairer. No, it will give you nutrition in the form of lot of electrolytes and So it's good to have light color food and coconut water, irrespective of whether it gives your baby white fair colored or not. It's not true. Then about certain food, it is said that few food causes or fruits causes miscarriage, like papaya, pineapple. Then the few food, like you are asked to avoid non-vegetarian food in the first trimester because it may cause abortion. So this is not true, because if you talk about the papaya, see, papaya you should have well ripe. If raw papaya contain a substance which may sometime initiate the uterine contraction, so you should avoid eating raw papaya, or for that matter any raw fruits or food. You should always have well ripe papaya, and pineapple is also good in pregnancy. You can have all this in pregnancy. It will never cause the miscarriage. About non-vegetarian foods, you should always eat well cooked food in pregnancy. Eating raw or uncooked or partially cooked is bad in pregnancy. So there is altogether different causes of miscarriages in pregnancy. So if you want to know that, I have a video on this. Do check it, all the reasons and the causes of miscarriages in that video. Now, it is said that taking a herbal tea or few tonics may make your baby intelligent. As I again explained, you all did that depend on you and your partner's genetic thing. No tonic or herbal tea. In fact, herbal tea you should not take in pregnancy. This is not going to change the intelligence level of the baby. In fact, it may be harmful to your baby. Then it is again one of the myths is full fat or full cream milk is always better than low fat milk. See, the difference between all this is only of the fat content. Otherwise, all the nutrients are same in full cream milk or low fat milk. So if you are on the heavier side or your weight is more, you have a slight chances of gestational diabetes, then you should always avoid the high full cream milk. You can equally take low fat milk. Both are equally good in pregnancy. Now, what you should avoid in pregnancy? You should avoid eating raw food. You should eat well cooked food. You should not eat unprocessed cheese. Then unpasteurized milk you should avoid. Then avoid alcohol in pregnancy. Avoid eating fish which contain the mercury. And about tea and coffee, limit your intake of tea and coffee to 1 to 2 cup daily. Now coming to the cravings in pregnancy. So we have seen that most of the female have the craving for something to other, for some food or the other. Craving as such is not bad. For some, you can, it is said that craving is not because of that specific item, but it is because of the special, one of the nutrient or one of the thing in that which your body may be missing or may be requiring. Like if you want to eat, if you feel like eating pickles, it may be your body needs more of sodium. If you are reaching for that french fries, maybe your body is needing potassium and sodium. And if you want to eat that chocolate ice cream or any ice cream, maybe your body's requirement of calcium is there and your body required more of calcium. So most of the time, it's cravings are always, it's not dangerous and it's okay to have the cravings and you can have that. But sometimes, and as I said, the craving is because of the one of the nutrients which your body may be lacking. So you may have to find out which your body is lacking, and you can take that, and then your cravings may be reduced. And to some extent, you can have all those food. That is not of any dangerous thing to have few cravings in pregnancy, is absolutely okay. But when the cravings are for the non-food items, like when the cravings for few females start eating clay, then crayons, then dirt, then these are the dangerous thing. This is known as pica. This is dangerous because when they eat this, then there is a chances of mercury or lead going inside your, especially lead going inside body, which can be dangerous for your baby, and it can cause some behavioral or developmental changes in the baby. So normal food cravings are absolutely okay if to some extent it is not too much. If you are not eating too much of pickles or french fries or ice cream, then it is okay sometime. But whenever you have a craving for non-food item, please notify your doctor urgently so that he or she will find out which deficiency you have. Sometime it is said that deficiency of iron or zinc may be related to the this habit of pica, like eating a dirt or clay or crayons. So recognizing that and treating that may be very helpful. So my take home message about diet in pregnancy is you should have a healthy diet in pregnancy. There's no magic thing about diet in pregnancy, but see to it you eat healthy, small, frequent meals, and your diet should include complex carbohydrate, protein, sufficient protein, healthy fats, vitamins and minerals. You should take plenty of amount of water. You should avoid raw food, and you should have small and frequent meals. I hope you like this video. Do like, comment and share. Thank you.